Now comes Newland's law of octaves, another beautiful law. In 1865, an English chemist named John A.R. Newland found out that the elements known at that time, means whichever elements were known at that time, were arranged in increasing order of their atomic weights. So what now you have understood what till now, that whichever elements were known at that time were arranged in increasing order of their atomic weights. The properties of every 8 element were similar to those of the first one. Now, what is the meaning of this? See, first of all, what he did was that whatever elements were known at that time, he arranged all of them in increasing order of their atomic weights. And when he increased, when he arranged them in increasing order of their atomic weights, what he discovered was that the property of the first element, property of every first element and every 8th element was same. I know many of you have not understood anything. Let's move on to the table which will help us to understand. See, this was the table which was put forth by Newland. And what he said was that the first element, let us assume that lithium is the first element. Now we count up to 8. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and 8th. So the first element is lithium and the 8th element is sodium. Now what he says is that lithium and sodium, they both will have same properties, that is similar properties. Similarly, if you assume beryllium to be 1, now count up to 8. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So what he said is that the first element beryllium and magnesium is going to have similar properties. He placed them one below the other. So now can I say that boron and aluminium is going to have the same properties? The carbon and silicon is going to have the same property. The nitrogen and phosphorus, they both are going to have the same properties, similar properties, guys. And oxygen and sulfur is going to have the similar properties. Fluorine and chlorine is going to have similar properties. And here, can I say that sodium and potassium are going to have the same properties, whereas magnesium and calcium is going to have the same properties. Now what I want you all to observe over here, see, lithium and sodium are having same properties and sodium and potassium is having same properties. Now since all three are having same properties, so can I say that lithium will be having same property like the potassium? Similarly, beryllium, magnesium and calcium, they all have same property, similar properties. So now can I say, guys, that all the elements in the vertical columns are going to have the similar properties. So all the elements which are in the vertical columns are going to have the similar properties. Okay, so now everything was fine for Newland. But here comes a problem now. Newland was able to arrange these elements in the system where the first element is having the similar properties like the 8th element only up to calcium. His law worked only up to calcium. It did not work for atomic weights ahead of calcium. So it was not applicable for elements ahead of calcium. Hence, it is obvious that Newland's law has to be rejected. And the main reason for the Newland's law of octaves to get rejected is because of the discovery of inert gases. The inert gases had drastically different properties from these elements which are known. And as a result, the Newland's law of octaves got disturbed and he was not able to arrange the further on elements. So, but this law was rejected, as we have seen. The inert gas were found to be quite different from other elements, and this had a great impact on the Newlyn's law of octaves. So guys, do check out my channel where I have uploaded chemistry and physics videos. They might be helpful for y'all, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more such interesting videos. And thank you for watching this video.